Master, are you alone and sick at heart?
What is it?
Do you know this lady, Baba the Turk?
I have not visited St. Giles' Fair as yet. They say that brave warriors who never flinched at the sound of musketry have swooned after a mere glimpse of her. Is such a thing possible in nature?
Two noted physicians have sworn that she is no imposter. Would you go see her?
Nick, I know that manner of yours. You have some scheme afoot. Come, sir, out with it.
Consider her picture.
Would you see me turned to stone?
Do you desire her?
Like the gout or the falling sickness.
Are you obliged to her?
Heaven forbid.
Then marry her.
Have you taken leave of your senses?
I was never saner. Come, master, observe the host of mankind. How are they? Wretched. Why? Because they are not free. Why? Because the giddy multitude are driven by the unpredictable mass of their pleasures. And the sober few are bound by the inflexible laws of their beauty, between which slaveries there is nothing to choose. Would you be happy, then learn to act freely? Would you act freely, then learn to ignore those twin tyrants of appetite and conscience? Therefore, I counsel you, master, take Baba the Turk to wife. Consider her picture once more, and as you do so, reflect upon my words. Oh. In youth, the panting slave pursues the fairy evasive dame. Then caught in colder fetters, whose wealth or this or a name, till cold, dishonored, sick, downcast, and failing in his wits, in virtue's narrow cell at last, the withered bosom sits. That man, that man alone, that man alone, his fate will be.
Ha 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 ha
young and by old, by young and by old, by young and by old.
Come, how's it been? Our fate to know.
A favorite narration throughout the nation, remembered by all, in cottage and hall, with song and laughter forever after.
Perfume the well-dressed and look in your best. A battle of passion, eyes hinting fashion. See your carriage young, and upon your tongue, the gallant speeches that you will teach us.
For tongues will not tire around the fire. Oh, sitting at meat,
the shadow to guide,
the tale to repeat,
of seeing a bride,
going and wedding,
the
likewise the
marrying,
a father and a king,
a father and a king,
a father and a king,
what we celebrate,
as great,
and what is
glory
to me,
all the fire shall have great,
all the strength and power.
My heart, be faster, come, look on the shadow,
come, master, come.
My wife, Anne.
Your wife? I see. Sleep.
la 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 la.
I wish it were true.
Awake!
Who's there?
Your shadow master!
On it! I've had the strangest dream. I thought, how could I know what I was never taught, or fancy objects I have never seen? I had devised a marvelous machine. An engine that converted stones to bread, where vile people's work for nothing fed. I saw a want abolished by my skill, and earth become an Eden of goodwill.
Did your machine look anything like this?
I must be still asleep. That is my dream.
How does it work?
I need a stone.
Try this.
I place it here. I turn the wheel. And then the bread.
Be certain. Taste. Upon your transports, but your dream is still a long way from fulfillment. Here is the machine, it is true, but it must be manufactured in great quantities. It must be advertised, it must be sold. We shall need money and advice, we shall need partners, merchants of probity.